glad you came today to celebrate Bach with us. And it's nice, too, to see many of our friends and supporters. We're going to start with some important housekeeping announcements. We will be recording today's concert, so please take a moment now to silence your phones and any other noise-making devices. Thank you. We ask, too, that you look through the program and support the local businesses that fund our concerts through their advertising. And today, we're offering a raffle for a $100 gift certificate to Burton's Grill in North Andover. If you want to be part of that raffle, please fill out the form in your program and put it in the box during in the lobby during intermission or after the concert. And the winner will be notified later today. If you enjoy singing, consider joining us. Open rehearsals for our spring concert will be held Mondays for 2 weeks, beginning February 12th. And there's more information about this in our program and on the website. And join us on Sunday, May 5th, for Americana, a musical journey through our land. It's going to be a really nice concert. Thank you again for coming today, and enjoy this concert.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for coming to our concert today in celebration of Johann Sebastian Bach and his 300 years since his appointment as cantor of the St. Thomas Church in Leipzig, Germany. We have a wonderful program to you, not just celebrating the music of Bach, but also seeing the inspiration that he has had over the past 300 years. If you've read in the program notes, Bach was not the first candidate chosen for his appointment. It actually was gonna go to Telemann, but Telemann was not allowed to leave where he was. He was not allowed to be released from his current appointment. And so the council for St. Thomas had chosen to go down the list, and Bach was actually really low on the list for people to be chosen for that position. So it comes to beg the question, would we even have heard of Bach had he not been appointed to this position at St. Thomas's in Leipzig? So today's concert features a lot of his music, a lot of music by new composers that we'll have in our second half today. So thank you for being here today. That was Alleluia theme coming from Bach's Magnificat from Sicut Locutus Est, from his Magnificat. Our next piece is the Ave Maria by Bach with his prelude in C major, mixed with Gounod's Ave Maria.
Thank you.
As we are doing a little personnel change here, our final piece for the first half of our concert today is called Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, which if you've seen in the program notes, translates to thoughtless and fearless people, unstable people. This cantata was actually written for the Sunday of the liturgical season that we are currently on today. So this cantata was actually performed 300 years ago according to the liturgical church calendar. So it's very inspiring that we get to perform this cantata today. And I believe that there are other places today in honor of Bach that are also performing this cantata as a part of the liturgical calendar. We are joined today by four soloists, tenor Michael Marullo, bass John Salvi, mezzo-soprano Alexandra Dietrich, and soprano Emma Robertson.
Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, robben sich des Wortes Kraft, des Wortes Kraft. Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, robben sich des Wortes Kraft. Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, raben sich des Wortes Kraft, raben sich des Wortes Kraft. Ohne dem zu heben, dass es keine Nutzen schafft, keine Nutzen schafft, keine Nutzen schafft. Belial mit seinen Kindern sucht ohne dem zu hindern, dass es keine Nutzen, keine Nutzen schafft. Flattergeister, Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, raben sich des Wortes Kraft, des Wortes Kraft. Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, Leichtgesinnte Flattergeister, raben sich des Wortes Kraft. Belial, Belial, Belial mit seinen Kindern, suchet ohne dem zu hindern, dass es keine Nutzen schafft, keine Nutzen schafft, keine Nutzen schafft. Belial mit seinen Kindern, suchet ohne dem zu hindern, dass es keine Nutzen schafft.
Schicksal gestand verkehrte Seelen, so gleichsam man den Wegel sieht. Und wer will doch des Satans List erzählen, wenn er das Wort dem Herzen raubt, das an Verstande blinkt, den Schaden nicht versteht, noch glaubt. Es werden Felsen hitten, so groß und widerstehen, ihr Eigenheil verschätzen, ihr Eigenheil verschätzen und ein Zugunder gehen. Es wirkt ja Christi letztes Wort, das Felsen setze springen, des Engels und bewegtes Grabes Stein. Ja, Moses starb kann dort aus seinem Berge Wasser bringen. Willst du, o Herz, noch Härte
thank you.
The next half of our concert is part of a project that the Bach choir in England had done back during 2020 when they had the full country shut down due to COVID. They took six chorales from the St. Matthew Passion and composed, or they commissioned six composers to write a new choral piece in response to those six chorales. And we are going to perform for you today three of those six pieces, two of which are actually making their American premiere right here. So we're very excited to do this today. It was the hope that all three would be an American premiere, but James Madison University Singers got to it just before we did in their fall concert, and they did an excellent job premiering it. The two pieces that are American premieres today are Charlotte Harding's Glow, which is in response to O Sacred Head Surrounded, and James Wilson's Who Has Seen the Wind, which is in response to Commit Thy Way to Jesus. We are going to perform the chorales in English today, and for understanding and being reverent of the response to the chorales, we ask that you please hold your response or your applause until after Who Has Seen the Wind, just so that the response to the chorale has more of a context and does not get separated. Thank you very much.
Oh, sacred and
Last piece today is Bridge Over Troubled Water, and you're probably wondering, well, what does that have to do with Bach? Paul Simon, in an interview, had described his inspiration for some of the melody for Bridge Over Troubled Water coming from the chorale O Sacred Head Surrounded. And if you listen very carefully, you'll be able to hear a little bit of that. And I'll demonstrate that for you. So we have, oh, sacred head surrounded by crown of piercing thorn, which in turn for bridge over troubled water goes to, I'm not even remembering it right now. I need to look at my music. Wow, how embarrassing. When tears are in your eyes. So that part there was a kind of a homage to Bach and to the inspiration when Paul was trying to figure out, well, how is this melody really going to go? And he actually demonstrates playing the chorale on a guitar as well. I forget the name of the show, but it is in your program notes if you're ever curious. And it is on YouTube if you ever want to see that interview as well. So we are joined today by a wonderful group of brass and string and a little bit of a jazz combo today. So please enjoy our final selection, Bridge Over Troubled Water. Thank you again for being here today with us. If you are interested in knowing more, please visit our website, andoverchoralsociety.org, and be on the lookout for a new website coming out very soon. Thank you to two of our members, Sophia and Eric. Thank you very much for doing that. If you are interested in joining us, we have our two open rehearsals on February 12th and the 19th. And we will be doing, as was mentioned before, a concert featuring American music and also American poetry, and doing things that have really scoped out the American landscape of music. So thank you again for being here today, and please enjoy our final selection.
Thank you.